Did you know there are parametrically designed pre-made SketchUp assets that you can use the scale tool to size based on your model just like this? They're called Sizable Live Components, and I'm going to show you where to find them and how they work right now. Let's go to the model.
This is the Sizable Live Component collection on 3D Warehouse. This has all the live components that you can edit with the scale tool to inference to geometry in your model. And maybe there are more models than this that are sizable. Stick around to find out. But if you're not familiar with live components, they are a subscriber-only feature that they're designed with parameters, so you can edit them parametrically to change different attributes about them. So let's check one of them out here. Let's try this scissor lift. So I'll just download it right into my model next to Sri here. And this live component configuration dialog box will come up. And then, all live components are authored that you can adjust the parameters with these sliders. But some of the new scalable live components or sizable live components is you can select the component and then select the scale tool. And then you can see there's certain bounds that have been identified by this author for how you can change. Like traditionally, obviously, when you scale a component, it is not the right scale. See, it's all stretched out. But once I release the scale, it will reformat everything so that it is scaled properly. And the scissors are what's doing the lifting here, not the entire thing stretching up. Let's check out a couple other ones and see just how they work. So like I said, each of these are authored, individually, specifically to allow the scale tool to size them. Partition wall. So this looks like a wall, like a conference room or something. If you're setting up some, floor plans in an office building, you can use this to identify the particular conference rooms. Maybe this is a long, skinny one, or maybe just a little personal square one. So easy enough to show it in here, but I'll show it in a couple of in-context examples to hopefully give you a better idea of the possibilities you can use these sizable live components with. And I should mention too that configuring any live component is part of a subscription. So you can still download the component, but you can't configure it or use the sizable feature unless you have a subscription. So I just want to point that out. I have this kind of basic floor plan that I've drawn the walls in here. And suppose I want to start putting doors in to flesh this out and give a good representation of what this is going to look like. I'll pop over to my collection here, which is, for me, it's right here on the main page once it loads here. And you can just view more to go back to this, or like I said, the link is in the pinned comment as well. So I'll cruise down to find a door, interior door. Try to get it close here. And then I'll move it into the frame. And then I can just use these scale grips to scale right to the frame itself. And maybe I'll edit this material as well. This apartment is going to use a different style of door here. Maybe not so pink. Let's see. Okay. And then I will open this up a little bit. So you see the bounds of the component as I navigate in here. Open my field of view and give me a little more room to see what's going on. So the bounds of the component obviously have everything that's in the component, but that doesn't affect the scale. Meaning if I want to move this and add a closet door in here as well, just make a copy of this component and alley-oop, pardon my 3D mouse skills, 90 degrees, and duck right in here. Even though the component, like the door, is further in here, I can still use the scale just to scale right to the bounds that I want. I'll change the door opening, and then again change that color. So just a quick way to get some extra models in here, get them scaled to the right size, and that's helpful. If you want to add a couple things and end up looking like this. So I've added these doors just for kind of a little look of what the apartment would more feel like when you actually move in. Some of these other elements that I brought in were live components as well. So I just went to 3D Warehouse and then in the SketchUp libraries, looked up the 3D models and then went to, you know, kitchen and bathroom and home appliances just in order to grab a couple of these. And when I was testing them out, hey, guess what works? These are not in the Sizable collection, but these do respond to the scale tool. So I say, try this out for yourself. See if these work, because it seems like the content team over at the 3D Warehouse has been sneakily updating how some of these components are authored, and maybe they are scalable, even if they're not in the, I keep saying scalable and sizable. Sizable is what they are. You can use the scale tool to size them. So check these out. See if there are any that, fit your needs that also can be edited with the scale tool, because looks like some of them are hidden in here, and that would be really nice to be able to find out some extra components that you can use that maybe don't explicitly say that they're sizable. One last one I wanted to show too that I thought was interesting was, I know nothing about wood. You know, some people are very knowledgeable about using wood. I am not, but I would like a shed for my extra tools that won't fit in my garage. Hey, I can use this Sizable Live component to quickly get an idea of what the framing for that shed might look like. So I will move these into place, size it to fit my slab here, and then I'm gonna say I want a slope top on my shed. And actually this one will not have the door, so I'll change the door and then move the window towards the middle here somewhere. Make a copy of this off to the other side. One thing too is that live components come in your components browser just like any other component, so you can always access them here as well. Just make sure not to purge them if they're not used in your model. Make another one and make this unique so that I can make this flat, add a door, no window. What I think is nice about this is I don't really know anything about framing, but this, you know, depending on my changing the size of these will automatically fix the framing, and you can change the settings in here if you like it a certain way. I don't really have a preference because I don't know what I'm doing, but there you go. Just a quick and easy way to get a little shed for my backyard with the automatic sizable live components that are now within SketchUp on the 3D Warehouse. Check it out for yourself.
All of the sizable live components in that collection, and I guess apparently all the secret ones that are not in that collection too, but still are able to be used with the scale tool, are really cool. And they're always making more of them too. One thing I forgot to mention is that all the live components, besides the doors that were in that apartment model that I showed, those were all live components, not in the collection, but still able to be resized with the scale tool. So check out the different ones and see, you know, if they work for what you need. What kind of models would you find most useful, most relevant to your workflow that you'd be able to, you know, use the scale tool to size them and inference to geometry in your model? Let me know in the comments. And as always, thanks for watching and take it easy.